as our session specifies, archaeology can bond people to the land they live in. Although it is an instrument to study the past, archaeology can also help modern society to find novel identities. For the last decades, we have witnessed the accelerated loss of identity experienced by traditional societies, to cite only the case of Romania. Here, not only communism, but also globalization contributed to the eradication of the traditional rural community's culture. The present paper describes implication of an experimental archaeology project with social repercussions spanning 16 years, which through the reproduction of local ancient technologies taught local history, creating a bond between rural community and its dwelling place. This experiment was carried out between 2000 and 2016 in the eponymous Vădastra site from the southern of Romania. Vădastra village is, I think, representative of the challenges facing the contemporary Romanian countryside in terms of economic and cultural re-evaluation and adaptations. For centuries, Romania was predominantly a traditional agrarian country where old folk customs were preserved in non-urban areas. After 1947, the communist regime tried to control the rural population through a process of collectivization and eradication of local traditions, replacing authentic folklore and local history with a counterfeit version meant to sustain the dominant ideology. In 21st century Romania, the majority of young villagers are migrating either abroad or to country's urban centers in search of increased prosperity. Vădastra village represents also a significant landmark in the evolution of prehistory as a research field in Romania. The discovery of the now well-known Vădastra calcolithic site coincided with the first archaeological studies in the country and the first developments towards a unified national culture. Over the ensuing years, the site gained a reputation on account of the abundance of typical calcite incised black ceramics. However, the discovery went unreported in the educational literature, and Vădastra's ancient past has not secured a place in the consciousness of contemporary community. In an attempt to rectify this situation, the Vădastra project I coordinated tried to draw the attention of the local community to the local past and make the past culture known again. As an experimental archaeology and education project, in addition to specific scientific objective of experimental archaeology, it started by teaching village children local prehistory and history while also offering them the opportunity to acquire an additional skill. Centered close to the Calcolithic eponymous site, the project was initiated in 2000. The hope was that by disseminating the expert knowledge learned through archaeological experiments and hands-on activities and by teaching the villagers about the local past, a center for the production of traditional ceramics could be developed at Vădastra. It was hoped that the establishment of such a center might create new jobs and provide an incentive for the village young people to stay instead of migrating to the cities. Therefore, results of any experiments conducted with ancient technologies were almost immediately transferred to the people in the village. Based on my strong belief in the power, power of significance of the context, at the outset I scheduled the experiments to be conducted in different locations of the prehistoric site. Taking into account that a greater part of experimental archaeology activity is still decontextualized, because experimenters work in contexts different from the originals, the project became a mix of scientific experiment and experientiality. This was achieved by conducting the experiment in a reconstructed context, in a sort of geostatic description. This is the reason why, for the archaeological experiment as well as for teaching in context, I have built part of the prehistoric and antique architectural context, such as the prehistoric house surrounded by palisade and the works of a Roman villa as places to host experiments. The following provides a short description of the different experiments carried out. Exercises designed to acquaint the children with prehistoric art in Vadasa began in the summer of 2001. At this level of instruction, children learn a number of basic rules of prehistoric visual grammars. Between 2000 and 2009, a series of sunken rapkins dug into the local clay terraces, as well as several surface and sunken kilns that were built in the village and their firing, involved both young and adult people from the community. Between 2003 and 2014, with the assistance of the villagers, three water and dab houses and a double palisade were constructed for the purpose of testing prehistoric and traditional building technique and to produce realistic contexts for reenactments with prehistoric technologies. Near the place where I identified a Villa Rustica, we constructed a Roman workshop containing a furnace for glass blowing, a furnace for ore melting, and other pyro and architectural features. Starting in 2005 up to 2012, a series of experiments with iron production were carried out along with experiments with Roman ceramics. Between 2012 and 2014, a series of experiments with prehistoric looms or Roman looms produced replicas of different types of woven textiles. One of the first people to be convinced of the positive social implication of this project was a man in his 30s. Possessing innate talent, after 1 year, he was able to make vases to rival those crafted by the art students involved in the project. By 2002, he had reached a level of craftsmanship that enabled him to gain a job as a ceramic instructor at the cultural house in Vadastra. This was followed by the introduction of modeling and vase decoration courses at the Vadastra school curricula, and to the emergence of a new local ceramic style inspired from the prehistoric one. The ethics of this method being discussed during a roundtable at EAA in Esslingen. One approach selected to increase the number of people interested in the project and to familiarize both children and adults with their local heritage was the Vadastra Tactile Museum. It created the premises of a sensory experience that would appeal to many senses and would take place in different local settings in close proximity to the archaeological ones in order to relate the sensory experience to the material culture in context. As a continuation to this experiment, a virtual museum was designed, placing into the virtually reconstructed context both the development of the chaîne opératoire and the reenactment of the technologies. As the time allotted during the summer campaign to the interaction with the community was not sufficient, beginning with 2011, the method of distance learning was adopted. We have used it as a solution to facilitate the access to education not only for Vadastra, but also for other remote and economically disadvantaged community by initiating a new educational project, The Maps of Time, Real Communities, Virtual World, Experimented Past, linking these communities to the research center and urban education institute, including Portugal. We work a lot with communities from Portugal. Vadastra was linked to other Romanian and European communities eager to rediscover their traditional identity through a platform with complex information containing a series of educational facilities, including e-learning. Educational materials about ancient technology were presented to the communities via Skype. In the image from the right, there's a link with Abrantes, with the community of Abrantes in Portugal. From the beginning of the project, art was employed as an educational instrument. Hence, the making in 2002 of a large graffito on the main facade of the cultural house in Vadastra illustrated the decorative patterns of calcolithic Vadastra ceramics. Another educational method used to present the archaeological data of a place was the augmentation of reality, also employing art. In a first approach, land art and installation were utilized to visualize data invisible today, such as paleo rivers or settlements. This was followed by the use of digital art to reconstruct the contexts. Because Vadastra's archaeological remains were fragmentary, we adopted virtual reality as our tool reconstructing objects ranging from vases to houses in 3D. These were then presented to the children together with real shards, hence allowing them to relate the sensory experience to real artifacts. All the technology of the archaeological experiments were demonstrated by diverse technicians dressed in costumes related to the respective epoch and carried out in the reconstructed architectural context, a prehistoric village, or the workshop of a Roman villa. Okay. Positioned near the archaeological remains. In this evocative way, people, objects, and technologies were linked to a specific place. In 2011, a new type of museum, a virtual one, began to present the local technology in a reconstructed real and virtual context. The advantages of this type of museums are the following. The virtual museum first allows visitors to travel in time into the room which exhibits Roman objects, reconstruction of the fragments found in the village and the nearby region. Then, to the prehistoric past into the room displaying a calculated house together with reconstructed prehistoric everyday life objects. The next stage of the educational strategy involved the creative use of the same visual material, including virtual reconstructions and video reenactments, used under the form of an educational game to achieve a more complex linking of the community and the place. One mobile phone application designed in 2013, labeled Archaeology at Home, involved an exploratory contextual learning. Using the smartphone, the children and adults explore the village surrounding area. Once reached, the defined places of interest triggered an augmentation of the geographical context like video, sound, text, 3D models, etc. For example, the ruins of a reconstruction of a prehistoric house that once identified by the device GPS triggered a series of images and 3D models of the whole house and then of the prehistoric ceramic technology inside the house. As a conclusion, one can state it is possible to use the past to create new identities. This must be seen as a positive effect of archaeological work. It could work as an example of how archaeology can be put at an immediate social use in the present. The presented project showed that archaeology should use education to create new skills and crafts, to implement new technologies, and to create new bonds between people and the place they live in. It also showed the power of learning in context. This is clearly an efficient method, which provides learners with a better and more complex understanding of the topic studied. Real and virtual museums could be used to develop awareness of the local past, especially among young people, in the same way as the IT mobile phone application, enabling an efficient transmission of the experimental archaeology and reenactments to the community, allowing people to immerse in the land they live in. The Vadasla project demonstrated that archaeology can both save and create identities, namely the creation of a spiritual connection of humans with one place. Thank you very much for your attention.